Welcome back, boys and girls and families. Last week we celebrated the Feast of Tabernacles, and we talked about the celebration of Yeshua coming to earth and dwelling among us, Emmanuel, God with us. John chapter 1 says that the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. That's Yeshua. Yeshua is the living Word. Well, we know that Yeshua grew up, died on the cross to save us from our sin, but he didn't stay dead, did he? Yeshua is still alive. And the Word tells us that he is preparing a place where we can go someday to dwell with him forever and ever, where we can tabernacle with the Lord. That's his great plan for us. But boys and girls, we have to be ready. We have to be prepared for his coming. The Word tells us that no one knows the hour or the day when Messiah Yeshua will return, but we must be ready at all times. Yeshua tells a parable in Matthew 25 about 10 young maidens who were waiting for the Lord.
At that time, the kingdom of heaven will be like 10 maidens who took their lamps and went out to meet the bridegroom. 5 of them were foolish and 5 were wise. The foolish ones took their lamps, but did not take any extra oil with them. The wise ones, however, took oil in jars along with their lamps. The bridegroom was a long time in coming, and they all became drowsy and fell asleep. At midnight, the cry rang out, "The bridegroom's here! Here's the bridegroom! Come out and meet him!" Then all the young maidens woke up and trimmed their lamps. The foolish ones said to the wise, "Give us some of your oil. Our lamps are going out. We don't have enough oil." "No," they replied, "there may not be enough for both you and us. Instead, go to those who sell oil and buy some for yourselves." While they were on their way to buy some oil, the bridegroom arrived. The maidens who were ready went with him to the wedding banquet, and the door was shut. Later, the others came back. They knocked on the door and said, "Lord, Lord, open the door for us, please." But he replied, "Truly I tell you, I don't know who you are."
Are you ready for the Lord's return? It starts by knowing Yeshua as our Lord and Savior, as our living Messiah. So if you'd like to receive the Lord right now, just pray these words after me. Dear Yeshua, please come into my heart. Come into my life. Be my Lord and Savior. Wash away my sin and make me your very own. In your name, amen. Just a simple prayer like that. Immediately when we pray that prayer, we are ushered into the kingdom of God. We have everlasting life with Yeshua. Everlasting life doesn't begin when Yeshua returns. It begins now. If you said that prayer and asked Yeshua into your heart and life, you are dwelling with the Lord already, tabernacling with the Lord. We have his very presence with us through the power of the Holy Spirit. So boys and girls, I just want to encourage you to always anticipate the coming of the Lord. Live in such a way, knowing that Yeshua could return at any second. So we must be ready. Hi, Aunt Cheryl.
Hey, BJ.
Wow. Thanks for joining me and my little sukkah.
Oh, we've had fun this week.
Thanks for inviting me. Oh, you're welcome. This has been awesome. Have you boys and girls enjoyed your sukkahs? I hope so.
We have, haven't we?
Yep, we sure have. We've had fun eating food and playing games and hanging out.
Yeah. Oh, and BJ, I'm just so excited. I love the reminder. I love the tabernacle and reminding us that God is with us, Amen. Emmanuel. But you know, BJ,
what?
I mean, we will have to take it down. It doesn't stay up. It's temporary.
It's temporary, that's
right. But God with us isn't temporary.
That's right. He's always with us, Aunt Cheryl.
He is.
Yep, the Word tells us that he never leaves us or forsakes us.
No.
He's always with us.
And remember, we're tabernacles.
That's right.
We're a tabernacle for the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Who lives in us. He's with us. He's yep. in us. And it's so exciting.
It is.
Did you hear the story Mr. Rick talked about?
Yeah, about the young maidens who five of them had oil for their lamps and they trimmed their wicks and they were ready for the Lord's return.
They were.
But five of them weren't.
No, they said, I'll get it later.
Yeah.
And then, oh my goodness, we need to go.
Yeah, but it was too late, Aunt Cheryl.
It was too late. Ooh.
By the time they got to the banquet, the door was closed and the master said he didn't even know them.
Isn't that sad?
Ooh.
But you know, that parable is about us being ready.
Yep.
For the Lord's return.
We have to be ready, Aunt Cheryl. We got to live our lives for Yeshua every day.
Yes, and we have to have that oil, the oil of the Holy Spirit in us.
Holy Spirit in us.
So it burns.
Yep, amen.
See, we can't be dried up and just, whatever. No, we need to be ready and we need to be watching for the Lord.
And pray, the Bible says.
Yes, yep. And, you know, we need to think about others.
Yep, we got to be telling others about Yeshua because we don't want anybody left behind.
No.
No?
I don't want anyone to
Me
be left
neither.
Behind. So make sure you're ready, but then make sure that your friends are ready.
Yep.
Your family's ready.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. And then we can all praise the Lord together.
Ooh, yeah, let's praise the Lord. One, two, three. Praise the Lord! Woo-wee!
Have a great week, boys and girls.
Amen.
See you later.
See ya. God bless you.